Hello, I'm Bhavesh and I will be demonstrating strain gauge based load cells.
So first of all, load cells are transducers that convert mechanical force or weight into an electrical signal. They are commonly used in industries and they also have various scientific applications, for example to measure force or weight or pressure. Load cells can be categorized broadly based on their sensing technology such as strain gauge, hydraulic, capacitive or pneumatic load cells. Strain gauge load cells are the most commonly used type and they use a Wheatstone bridge circuit to measure the change in resistance of a strain gauge due to an applied force. The load cell that has been given to us works in the following way. The load is applied at one end of the load cell and this causes tension or compression to occur at various locations on the structure of the load cell. And now if we attach strain gauges at these specific locations and configure them in a Wheatstone bridge circuit, then we can measure the voltage difference across the bridge, and this voltage difference will be proportional to the applied load. It should also be noted that the Wheatstone bridge can either be in a full bridge configuration or a half bridge configuration, but full bridge is better because it is more sensitive than half bridge configuration. We will now see how to perform the experiment. The first step is to make all the connections properly. The connections coming out from load cell are connected in the following fashion. We also have to connect the jumper connection so that the readings can be displayed. Now the power is on. As can be seen, even though there is no load applied, the reading is non-zero. So we will zero adjust it by turning the zero adjust knob. Turn it until the reading is zero. Now it's zero adjusted. The second step is to calibrate the load cell by putting 1 kg load on the load cell. The reading is 0.81, but it should be 1. So calibrate it by turning the adder knob. Now it's calibrated. Now that the load cell is calibrated, take reading in increasing mode and decreasing mode. In each mode, increment or decrement by 100 grams as shown. These are the readings of the experiment in tabular form. So load cells are basically sensors that are used to measure force or weight, and they have a variety of applications. Load cells work on the principle of strain measurement, where a strain gauge mounted on a beam or other structure deforms under load. Strain gauge measures the strain in the structure, which is proportional to the load being applied. Load cells can also experience hysteresis, which is the phenomenon in which the current output depends not only on the current input but also on the history of the loading. Hysteresis in load cells can cause errors in the measured output due to the residual deformation. So a regular calibration of load cells is required to maintain the accuracy and reliability of the load cell. One of the innovative application of load cell could be in smart trash cans. The world generates more than 2 billion tons of waste every year, and this number is of course expected to rise. Waste management is a significant challenge and it requires innovative solutions to optimize collection and to reduce environmental impact. So smart trash cans with load cell technology could be a promising solution to this problem. So what happens basically in a smart trash can is there is a load cell attached in a trash can which monitors the weight of the waste in real time. The load cells can help waste management companies optimize collection schedules based on the actual amount of trash generated. रिड्यूसिंग कलेक्शन फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड कॉस्ट्स। रियल टाइम डेटा ऑन ट्रैश लेवल्स कैन हेल्प वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट कंपनीज ऑप्टिमाइज देयर ऑपरेशंस, लीडिंग टू मोर एफिशिएंट वेस्ट सॉर्टिंग, रिसाइकलिंग एंड डिस्पोजल। ऑल्सो ऑप्टिमाइजिंग वेस्ट कलेक्शन रिड्यूसेस कार्बन एमिशंस एसोसिएटेड विद द वेस्ट कलेक्शन ट्रक्स एंड इट प्रमोट्स अ मोर सस्टेनेबल अप्रोच टू वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट।